So continuing on with this example, we've handled this input mismatch exception error, but that's just one error. There's a gazillion different errors that we can get. And so one of the ones that we can look at is on with arrays. If we create an array called let's create a string array called places my office is hotter than. Okay. So this array is places my office is hotter than. That's the name of it. And so we're going to set this array. Now I didn't even know if I told you can do this because we can set it equal to a new string array with a number of elements. So I'll do five elements. Okay. So we can go in and say places my office. I really should have picked a shorter name. Hotter than. Okay. Places my office is hotter than element 0 is equal to molten lava. Okay, so that's place one. But what I was going to tell you is we can actually, if we know what we want to put into the array in the beginning, we don't need to do it like this with each individual array. I can just set it equal to opening curly brace and then just go ahead and type the different fields I want in there. So one is molten lava. Two, obviously the sun. Three, now let's see how I can do this. Can I just drop down to another line? I don't know if it'll let me do this or not. We'll try it. What's the next thing? Whoops. Texas in July. The cornballer. And, of course, hell. Okay, so these are the places my office is hotter than right now. And now those are in an array, and that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different elements. It's going to create a five-element array with those different places, right? And let me see if this will compile. I can't remember the syntax if you're dropping down to the next line. Seems like it liked it okay. Okay, so after I ask for the shoe size, I'm going to put in a little thing here, system.out.println. My office is hot. How hot is it? System.out.println. It is hotter than dot dot dot. And then I'll create a little loop to run through the different elements of the array. So for an int I beginning at element 0 and going while I is less than element 5, because there's five elements in the array, I plus plus. Okay, so now we'll just make a list here. System.out.println, and what we're going to print is places my office is hotter than okay, and what element are we going to print? Well, it will depend on which time we are through the loop. So we want to put I in there so it'll rotate each time we come through the loop. And so now if I run this program, this is a very special program here that asks first for your shoe size, 5, and then it goes through and prints out this information. My office is hot. How hot is it? It is hotter than molten lava, the sun, Texas in July, the cornballer, and hell. Okay. The problem is this. A lot of times we'll accidentally try to access an element that's outside the array. For example, a lot of times we'll say I is equal than or less than or equal to 5, thinking that 5 is the last element. If I run this program with the less than or equal to, after I type in the shoe size, then I'm going to get an error that says array index out of bounds exception. So this is a different exception. The other one was an input mismatch exception, and this is an array out index out of bounds exception. Okay, so what do we do in this situation? Well, we've got it inside a try. Why didn't it catch it? Well, because this was only built to catch the input mismatch exception. So what do? Well, we can have multiple catches with each try. So we can have a catch for the input mismatch exception. And then below that, I can just create another catch for the array index out of bounds exception. Okay, so this is a completely separate error. I'll just name it E again, the object that's coming in. And then I'll say system.out.println. Instead of having that big ugly message in the program crashes, I'll just say, whoops, looks like you went out of bounds. Okay, so that's what will happen if I get out of bounds. So now when I run this program, what's your shoe size? 14. And then it goes through. It runs this program. My office is hot. How hot is it? It is hotter than molten lava, the sun, Texas in July, the cornballer, and hell. And then at that point, it tries to access the fifth element of the array, or element five, which would be the sixth element of the array. When it tries to access element five on this last time through the loop, it'll jump down and look to see if there's a catch for that error, and there is, array index out of bounds exception, and so it'll jump into that error and print out this message. Whoops, looks like you went out of bounds, okay? And so notice there's only one try, but there's two catches. We can attach multiple catches to a try if that's what we're wanting to do. And we don't have to have just one try catch in the program. We can put 50 try catches in a program. We can block it out for each section. Whatever makes sense as we're writing the program is what we need to do. And so we use try catches all the time in real honest to goodness programming because we want to make the experience for the user as pleasant as possible. One last thing I want to point out with this. I could here set the error variable to true and have it go back up to the top and start over again, but then it would ask me about the shoe size again, even though, or I guess it would at least give me the chance to input the shoe size again, even though I entered it correctly the first time. And so that tells me that I probably ought to break this up into two separate try catches that each deals with its own thing. What you don't know is I'm laying my book on or arm on a book as I'm typing, and every time I lift up my arm, the page is sticking to it. That's what it's like in here right now. But that wasn't even what I was going to get at. What I was going to say is this. The array index out of bounds exception is an object that's being passed to us. It's got a bunch of information and methods that go with it to be able to tell us more information about the error that occurred. And the most simple one that we use all the time is instead of printing out, whoops, looks like you went out of bounds, I want to print the message for that error. And so I can do that by referring to the object that is passed into me, the array out of bounds in the array index out of bounds exception is I'm going to call E, and I could just as well call it the error. I could call it blah. I can call it Bob. I can call it whatever I want to, but whatever I call it, I need to then refer to that here by saying E dot, and one of the methods that's available to us is get message, opening closing parenthesis. That will give us the message that is built in, and sometimes those messages are helpful and sometimes they're not. So now if I say 10, sorry, that was not valid. So now I enter 10, and it's going to print out 5. So you know when I said that some messages are helpful and some are not? This is apparently one of the not category because I got a 5. Let's try it on the input mismatch exception. So here I'm going to, before I print out, sorry, that was not valid input, let's print out the e.get message for that one and see what it prints out. What's your shoe size? Blah. And the message here is even more helpful. It's null. Sorry, that was not valid input. Please re-enter if I enter something good. And then it gives me a 5. So these are both poor examples of, but sometimes the error message is actually helpful. What about if I don't know what kind of error I'm going to be getting? We can't account for everything, right? And so sometimes we need to, or we want to, create just a generic error. Okay. And we can do that by just after our other catch blocks, we can just add a catch block that says if we get any exception E, let's try this one. System.out.println. Let's print the message that goes with that exception. Get message. So this is just a generic, any error that we get should bring us to this exception. And so what's the shoe size? 10. Sorry, that was not valid input. The problem here is I've already got a catch set up for it. What can I do here? Comment that section out. Because I had a specific error in place for it, then it's going to go to that error. So 10. It caught the error, at least. It still caught the error, but the message is still null. So maybe I'm using a bad method. But I'm not, so. Anyway, we can get the class the error occurred in. It tells me the class is the input mismatch exception. That tells me the class of the error. But anyway, that's a way to handle a generic error if we want to just handle something generically. Obviously, it's better to handle it specifically if we can. And then work with generic errors in case we miss something. To make sure the program just doesn't crash. Because notice it still didn't crash. It won't crash here. It only ended because I told there's no code after to execute. But if I just put a generic, in fact, if I set error equal to true, when I get an exception, then notice even if I enter bad data, you know, then it's going to get that and just keep going forever because the buffer's still full of stuff. I need to flush the buffer before I do that. I'll do that quick. To get everything out of there. Blah. Then it prints the error. It's printing the class of the error. But then the program doesn't die. Because I just set up this generic exception to catch anything I didn't have an exception for already. So there's lots of different errors out there. And while we're programming, we want to make sure if we're programming well that we're keeping track of those errors and making sure we're handling them in a way that's not going to be upsetting to the user. All right, and that's errors. Spencer out.